Hello, everyone. Thanks for joining us here on Horizon. Well, it's called STEM, a simple acronym for subjects that could determine our nation's future. Science, technology, engineering, and math are all fields that currently do not produce enough employees to fill current job demand, a demand that goes beyond just the needs of industry, but impacts our entire way of life, even our national security. Joining me now is our Andy Barth.
Well, Rob, it seems that the STEM fields are here to stay. Employers are now looking for workers who have skills needed to operate in manufacturing and technology jobs. And student organizations are doing their part in getting students excited about STEM. Last week, we left you with the first robotics competition, which is where we pick up today's story.
From engineering to programming. Students involved in the first robotics competition are learning vital skills needed in today's workforce.
Oh well, when I came to robotics, I knew that this is what I was meant to do, that this is where I was supposed to be. I started the pre-engineering program at Gordon Cooper because I was interested in science and math.
Preston Warden is a student at Gordon Cooper Technology Center and says STEM classes are preparing him for his future.
I'm good, keep going.
Well, the courses at Gordon Cooper are very college-based. I take AP courses all the time, I take engineering courses all the time, and they definitely push you to do better than what you are now.
And Warden's robotics coach, Roger Ferris, says students are directed toward big careers.
We have students who work in research facilities, we have students who work for manufacturers, we have students who are at Tinkerfield, we have students who are at Boeing, we have students who have gone to NASA. The list goes on, and the opportunities are almost endless. It's hard to say where, they go everywhere.
And it's those job opportunities that brought both lawmakers and educators together to the first STEM Summit in Oklahoma City. Because STEM is much more than building robots. It's preparing students for vital careers in science, technology, engineering, and math.
It has built us to the success that we're in today.
Sophia Kim is the strategic relations manager at Northrop Grumman and says engineers are the new popular.
I think being a geek is a cool thing, you know? I think it's something that we have to strive towards.
And Kim says STEM is here to stay.
Everyone has to understand that STEM education is the infrastructure of the United States economy.
An education that starts well before college.
I think we need to start as early as possible. I think it's influenced by the teachers. I think it's influenced by family members.
And Oklahoma Secretary of Science and Technology, Stephen McKeever, says education and industry go hand in hand.
Industry and education need to be together in this game because it's not a problem that either side can fix by themselves.
And McKeever says education looks to industry for guidance.
In education, we need to know what kind of graduates we need to produce, how many of them we need to produce, and we need their help in energizing those young students into careers in STEM. So it's got to be a partnership.
And Michael Ming of GE Global Research says industry must support education in order to stay globally competitive.
Well, industry has clearly a vested interest. And so, they're going to be supporting universities. They're going to be supporting specific STEM activities. I think you'll see, in order to maintain the innovative edge, that corporations are going to reach out to support STEM because it's their lifeblood if you're in the technology business.
We have to be inclusive. We have to bring in women, especially in these engineering fields. I think women bring in a different perspective that I think brings a fresh new face on some of the problems that we have, some of the programs that we have.
Helping grow a workforce to fill the job demands for both today and tomorrow.
Well, now women who work in STEM careers earn an average of 33% more than their counterparts in other fields. Yet, they currently only make up 24% of the overall STEM workforce.
So it stands to reason if we want to increase the number of people going into the STEM fields, a good place to start is with that half of our population that is female.
Absolutely, Rob. Women are less likely to enter the STEM work fields and then more likely to leave earlier than their male counterparts. It's a problem that experts attribute to a cultural stereotype, which, while still subtle, still exists today.
All right. Thank you so much, Andy. Now, next week, we're going to meet some Oklahomans who have taken the road less traveled, trailblazing their own path to success. But when we return, I sit down with Oklahoma Governor Mary Fallon to talk about closing a skills gap in today's workforce.